Hello, guys. Where's the ball? The fool. Okay, let's go see the other fool. Buddy, we should have a piece of bread in our mouth. Buddy, buddy. Communicate. Okay, let me play with him. All right, let me show you a couple of things before we begin. First of all, I have placed the ornament, coat of arms, call it whatever you like. Let me show you. Take a look at this piece, where it goes and ends exactly here, where is a gap also on the other side. This wasn't happening, so to make that happen I had to unglue this part over here so I can stretch it, and also I have to bend this part carefully without breaking it also on the other side. That was very hard, very time consuming, but I made it happen. And the looks of her are unbelievable. So, this is one addition. The second addition, and we're going to see how it's done together, is, as you can see, in every gun port lead I have placed couple of ropes, like the real thing, so you can lift then the gun port lids up. Gives a tone of beauty, as I'll say. It's not hard, but before we begin, let me say a couple of things. The holes over here on the gun port lids are 0.8 millimeters. We've made it together, and the holes over here are 1 millimeter, just to make my life easier. You can make 0.8, but then you might have a little problem of passing the rope inside, and that's difficult. So 1 millimeter on the hull, 0.8 over here. And I have one lid over here that this will remain without gun port ropes, because there's no way I can drill over here and put anything. You can see it's very narrow, we're talking about 1 millimeter. I will have to destroy it. Everything. Maybe I will just glue a nut on the lower part just to make it look like the rest. So let's make a couple together to see how it's done. I'm using rope of scale. Rope of scale 0.45 millimeters. I find it easier to do that from above. You can do it the way you like it. I just find it easier from above. Because I'm right-handed, I'm doing the left first and then the right. just pour some glue over here to make it harder. Now, when you put it in, try to glue it and stretch it, because it should be stretched, because the gun port lid will pull it downwards, so it should be stretched as much as you can. It's not easy. Come, look here. I don't want that much glue. Let's do another one. So, I have a few more to do on this side and the entire other side. Let me do that and I'll get back to you to continue with what's next. So guys, I have decided what we're going to do, and this is going to take a lot of time, and we have to be very, very careful. I'm going to place the supports for the platforms and the supports for the dead eyes, and this is going to be hard, very hard. There are three different types. Here you can see them all. This is the long ones, the short ones, and these are the supports for the platforms. As you can see, I have cut one because these are longer than needed in most of the cases, and you have to cut and form them. But all of them must bend the plug. Of course, this means that we will have repainting again and again because we're going to work and we're going to use nails. This also have to open some holes in some occasions, probably all. It's going to be hard, but first of all, I have to paint them black. I was thinking about leaving them as it is, but then again, the side of the ship will look very different from the real one. So I decided to paint them black. It's going to be a pain in the you know what. So let me paint them and I'll get back to you. I painted them, of course. It's not the perfect paint, but I don't care about that. I just wanted to have them painted black. In the process of placing them, I will scratch them and I have to repaint them. But it's easier to make corrections than to paint the entire part. So that was the idea. That's why I don't care that over here is not painted or the tip is not painted. Don't care about at all. We'll begin by placing these pieces here, or maybe I will do a platform. I will do this platform for you, or this might seems easier. Probably this seems easier. This one will take longer. Of course, I'm not going to do the entire platform, just a couple of pieces, because every piece is going on with the same exact way. To show you something, let me zoom in. Okay, right there. These pieces here, you see the vertical on the rear are the big ones. Are these. These are the long ones, and this one is a short one. So you can see exactly where it goes and where you're going to nail it. This will be interesting. So let me get ready. Okay. Let's do the central one, and we're going to begin from here. Definitely I'm going to need to make some holes, but okay. First of all, let's bend this. This is going, let me check, right under this line. So it should go over here. As you can see, already started to the paint to come off. I hate that. Must cut here. The paint already gone. Let's see now. Need a little bit like that. Okay. course it will need repainting, no doubt about that. I've already destroyed the paint job, you can see that. Okay, got it. And since I'm here, let's check out to see if this is the correct. It is. It is the correct. I need five of them. So let me cut them and form them. So cut them and drill them. I made a small hole. Now let's place the first one. Okay, it's right here in the corner. Maybe before I place them, to form them like this, give me a moment. Okay. Now. Now I need to make a hole here. Don't know if you're able to see, but I definitely need to make a hole. 0.8 millimeters, that is. Now I need some nails. And now to glue. Of course, some correction of painting is definitely in order. Now let me put the next four with exactly the same way, and I'll get back to you to throw on the rest. Now we have long ones and short ones. Since I'm following exactly the drawing, the first two are long ones. This fit exactly here. Of course, what is going to be above the platform is going to be without paint. Maybe it was a mistake painting them. Let's see now where this goes. This goes above this one. This goes with an angle. Goes like that. Over there. Okay. Okay. Let's see where to make a hole. Oh, there's going to be a lot of painting to make that pieces black again. The second one, still a big one, and goes exactly next to the other one. To be more specific, goes let's put it on and we'll see. Let's throw on a small one and I will do the rest on my own, and I will show you the finished result as soon as I have finished the first one. Also, we have to throw on a couple of rings, but the rings is nothing serious, just cut it and glue it. Nothing specific about that. So, as I see, is three more long ones, one short. So we have one, two, three, one short here. This is the short, and the short goes no, this is not the short. Here is a short. I love it how the paint is destroyed. The sword, like I said, goes over here. This has to have a specific height because we're going to we're going to make a loop to hold on the dead eyes. So if I'm not leave a specific height, I'm going to have a problem. So I'm going to put it further
up. I shall say to avoid having a problem. And I'm going to put it over there. Why this one is a short one? It is, but why? It doesn't make any sense. Alright, let me move on, do some correction painting, and I'll get back to you to show you the finishing result. Cut them. Painted them. I can tell you, they look great. Of course, this will be corrected, because here you can have a loop to hold on the dead eyes. So this is going to be changed. So, from the platform and below, we are done. And looking great. Of course, I have to do many more. I also did this small one over here, and I have to do this one, this one, this one, of course, and the other side. That will take a lot of time, but the procedure is exactly the same, nothing different. I also throw on the ring here that I told you before. So, this is how we're going to do things. In our next video, I'm thinking about throwing on the chain over here. The chain is in this model is in copper color. It's supposed to paint it black, but will have exactly the same effect as this one. That's why I haven't painted the ring black, because over here is going to be a rope, and when the rope comes inside, the paint will go off and it will be ugly. But this little brass gold color is perfect. So the chain will be remain in copper. I'm not going to paint it, because it will look ugly after it has jiggled around and the paint is gone. And the problem with the chain is that you cannot paint it with paintbrush. It has very small holes and will be a mess. You need, of course, airbrush, and after I place it on, I'm not going to be able to repaint it. It's not like here. So the chain will remain its natural color and also will match the copper hole. So guys, this is it for today's video. Thank you very much for watching. Don't forget the Super Thanks ability, because I will need it now until at least I found a new job. And take a look at the recommendation that I have for you in the Model Central. You might find something very interesting. Thank you very much for watching. See you soon.